trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry.
Welcome to Making a Difference with Gail. Tonight I'm really excited because I have fabulous people who are going to share the different things they're doing in their lives to affect change in others. One of my guests, Mark Singer, is known as the Bench Mensch. Mensch, a Yiddish word, and it's a word about integrity. This is from a man who did the research in Long Beach and found out all the stories and information about the people whose lives have been inscripted on all of the benches. He covered, out of the 722, 150 in his first book. We're going to find out why somebody would do that, how it made a difference in his life, and also who are these people that he's talking about. We're also going to meet the owners, the originators of Network USA. I'm talking about Mike Aharoni and Bill Kwiatkowski, who are going to share with us what they're doing today that makes this so different in the world of networking. And I'm going to ask the owners of Manhouse TV, my very good friends, two men I absolutely adore, Tom Maley and Tommy Marr, to show and explain what we're going to be doing on the 16th of December, and all about Ronald McDonald. And we're going to share the background, the notes, what's going to happen. So when you come back, we're going to meet with Mark Singer, my first guest. Be right back.
Are you planning an event and want to include entertainment, but you're not sure where to turn?
Act1Entertainment.net has provided over 1,500 events with quality, affordable live entertainment at private parties, corporate affairs, festivals, bike rallies, and more. Act 1 will fit into your budget. They're friendly, reliable, and do all the legwork for you. They take all major credit cards. Log on to Act1Entertainment.net for a free, no-obligation price quote or call 631-758-3505 for a brochure.
You'll be happy you did.
Welcome to Formula Auto Wash, where every day is a great day for a car wash. Open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Sundays, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Detailing packages for every budget, starting out at $29.99. 100% hand wash and detail center. Hog's hair and microfiber brushes and mitts. Proudly using Ecolab Blue Coral soaps and waxes. Formula Auto Wash has served the community for over 30 years. Senior discounts all day, every day. Ladies Day Wednesday, $3 off any wash. Early bird discount Monday through Thursday till 9:30 a.m. Check out our website, formulaautowash.com.
Well, Like so many people, are your finances tight lately? Afraid to open your mail or even answer your phone? Well, take heart. You don't have to live like that. If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you can join the thousands of folks who have used safe and effective government-insured reverse mortgages. The government-insured reverse mortgages from Long Island's Senior Reverse Network allow you to stay in your home and turn equity into tax-free cash. Our government-insured reverse mortgages can eliminate mortgage payments, credit card balances, or just improve your lifestyle. Do yourself a favor and solve these problems now. Call the Senior Reverse Network, and our advisors will answer all of your questions about our reverse mortgage programs. We've helped scores of senior Long Island homeowners like you who now enjoy a worry-free retirement. Get the financial security and peace of mind you've dreamed about. Pick up the phone and call us at the Senior Reverse Network now to set up a free consultation.
Call 1-800-985-REVERSE. That's 1-800-985-7383.
Yes. Okay. All right. I have to correct that. It was the 14th of December. I think I'm feeling like everybody else, a little overwhelmed with the holidays. But that is the 14th at the Ronald McDonald House. And we'll all be there, and we'll talk about it later. And Jeff Singer, the author of this wonderful book, is going to share with us. Hello, how are you?
How are you doing, Gail?
I'm
pleasure to be
very
here.
Well, now you are also a former teacher of English.
That's correct.
Correct.
Yep.
And I have to tell you, you wrote the most incredible poem that I'd like to share with the audience. And what you have done is take all of these inscriptions and put this into a journal while you're sharing the stories of the many people from Long Beach. But you also tie it in with Superstorm Sandy. You must have been greatly affected in Long Beach with the storm.
Well, like so many of us were, I had started actually compiling these stories in August of 2012. And 3 months later, Superstorm Sandy came ashore. And that sort of put a crimp in the whole thing, obviously. And I sort of said to myself at that time, that's somewhat of an obstacle, but it's not going to stop this process. And I told everybody, even at that time, by the summer of 2013, this will be actually a reality. And I had hoped to get 150 stories, and right at the last day that I said no more stories, the 150th came in. So I did reach the goal right
on schedule. That you had set out for. May I share this with the audience, this beautiful poem?
Please.
Okay. Called Testament. This is an ode to the human spirit which proclaims that we will overcome. We will survive. We will rebuild. The eve of October 29th descended upon the Long Beach community with a vengeance. 722 benches looked out upon the wine-dark sea and knew it was angry. They stared at the roiling mass that was about to engulf them. And then she was upon them, with a howling and a gnashing of foam-flecked teeth, looking for that soft underbelly. Wet, salt-soaked fingers began its inexorable march toward the wooden structure that had stood for over 100 years. Enraged, she tore across the peninsula, devouring everything in her path. And still, the benches remained. These wooden sentinels, memorializing 1,000 loved ones, would not yield an inch to her malevolence. Hours on, and the battle raged. 722 Davids against one insatiable Goliath. And then it was finally over. Sandy had sated her appetite, moved on looking for a next prey. When dawn arrived on Halloween Day, all the evil spirits had been vanquished. And still they stood. Over 700 had survived intact, having triumphed over all the terror that Mother Nature could muster. But they were all there to greet the morning sun, still staring at the unflinching horizon, a true testament to the enduring power of both faith and love. Jeff, share a little bit about that with me.
Yeah, I think that came to me, so to speak, probably about 3 months after the storm hit. And I knew that this would be a, sort of a commemorative, not only, of course, of all the tribute benches that I dealt with, but also of what we had to endure after October 29th, and we're still enduring. And it just sort of came to me, and I connected with, it's more biblical, because there is Goliath, there's
you have
Testament,
your allusions
there's,
to the
there
Bible,
are images.
Absolutely.
And that was obviously on purpose. And yet, you know, that's the faith-based part of it. And then the benches sort of symbolically got there as well. And I just felt the emotion as I was writing it. I said, this is right. This is the way I want to do it.
Well, let me ask you a little bit about that. I mean, I have also sat on different benches and wondered about the person. Sometimes there were balloons, there were whales, there were inscriptions. Mm. And that's probably got you going as to who are these people and why are they?
Yeah. I had gotten myself, I had mm-hmm. gotten a surprise back on about December 20th, 10 years ago, actually for my 60th birthday.
Right, which we'll get. Mm.
Okay. I was given a bench. And
yeah.
In the ensuing time, 10 years or so, I had many times sat on benches. And this is to Uncle Louis, a great, you know, one of my favorite people in tribute and memory. And I wondered who Uncle Louis was.
Right, whose uncle was he? I also want to ask you, how does one go about getting all of this information for all of these benches? That's some task. And
it was a bit daunting at first, yes, because we really had to get my name out there. Right. And I had to get my project out there.
Okay.
After... you know, again, a lot of it's timing, a lot of it's luck. I managed to actually get a few of the journalists, writers mm-hmm. for Newsday, the Long Beach Herald,
right.
Channel 12.
Okay.
And once I got that type of publicity, it started to flow. And you know,
were you able to go to public records? Would they give information like this out?
No.
Not at all. You were on your own with it.
Yeah. So when they... heard there was a fellow called the Benchmensch, myself, mm-hmm. and he was doing this project. Right. You know, there's 700 and some odd out there, and slowly but surely, I think when the superstorm hit, I had about 40 or 45 stories that I was working on.
Right.
And then it wasn't gelling, and my personality says, come on, let's go, let's go. But again, faith and the belief that this will happen kept me going.
Why do you think this is so important to the people?
As many of them have told me, mm-hmm. they said their loved ones who are buried hither and yon, wherever they are, they said they don't go there very often, but they always go to the bench, because the bench, it's who they were. It's almost all of them obviously have the memories of the parents, the grandparents, whomever, sitting on that particular bench, not the bench itself, but that spot where the bench was put on.
Right.
And it gives them so much solace. And they commune with these departed.
You know, I think you're right. There are many people who can go to grave sites, and there are some who can't. There are people whose ashes have been interred, and they want to go back to the place where they have so many memories. Do the people all have to be from Long Beach who are commemorated on the benches?
No, but I would say a good, they don't have to be. I would say 90%, maybe more. They're not all memorial benches. I call it the tribute benches.
Tribute benches.
There's probably about, I would say, yeah, 5, maybe as many as 10% are that. You know, I'm an example, a living example, if you will.
Okay.
Mine is not a memorial bench. So there are, you know, probably another 50 or 60 like me who just fortunately got this tribute bench. And... live to tell the tale.
How has this made a difference in your life?
Well, you know, I'm not the youngest guy on the block anymore, and I always wanted to be able to affect people in a very positive way. And I myself was sort of surprised that when the book did come out
mm-hmm.
and people started to read it, it was almost a catharsis. It was a very, very, very emotional experience for just about anyone who read the book. And that's quite gratifying.
And you know what I found too that was so exciting is that, yes, you do have so many people who have made incredible differences in the lives of others, But you know, you could be at the supermarket and talking to somebody, not realize the story that that person has. We all have amazing stories that are eventually unveiled. Why don't we talk a little bit about a few of them? You have over 100 people out of the 150 stories memorialized, and these are our heroes from 9/11. And one of the families were the Haskell brothers, who come from a family of firefighters. And what we're going to do is show the pictures and then maybe read a little bit from the book to commemorate who these people are and how they were so heroic. So the person that I have is Tommy Haskell, and you're going to read about Timmy Haskell. Thomas Haskell was the battalion chief of Ladder 132. Timothy Haskell, his younger brother, firefighter of Squad 18. No greater love has anyone than this, that he laid down his life for another. Heroes for eternity, brothers bravest in life and battle, 9/11/01. Tommy was driven to be the best he could be. He joined the fire department of New York at 21 while still a senior at St. John's University, rose quickly, and by the age of 37 became battalion chief. On 9/11, Tommy led his men from Ladder 132 into the South Tower at the World Trade Center, assisting in evacuation efforts. Despite unimaginable horrors, Tommy saved as many lives as possible till he was lost in the first collapse. Tommy displayed bravery that inspired our country and is remembered with pride and love. Timmy?
Well, Timmy's actual tribute plaque says the following. Courageous and compassionate, their selfless acts inspired a nation and personifies the American spirit. Their valor under the most extreme conditions helped save countless lives. This plaque serves as a testament to their heroic contribution to humanity and a reminder to all who view it to live life to the fullest, as the Haskell brothers did. God bless America.
You also told me before that there was another firefighter that had sacrificed his life. Can you tell us a little bit? Because I know that that really impacted upon you.
Yes, and it certainly did on many, many, many people.
Many people.
His name was Stephen Siller. Stephen also has a bench. He is most known for what's called the T-to-T run. This was when Stephen was actually out on the links playing golf when he got the news. He was the fireman. He got the news that what was going on in the towers, and he immediately jumped into his van, and he started driving toward the city, and he got stuck in the Holland Tunnel, and I guess without thinking, he jumped out of the truck. He strapped on his gear, and he actually ran from the tunnel
into
the tower, where he led a squadron of men. And unfortunately, he passed away. As a result, the foundation, the T-to-T, I believe it's called the foundation, was formed by his family, mainly his brothers. And every year around that date, there's a run from Holland Tunnel to the towers. And now there are, I don't know how many thousands do that. Many
amazing?
People, I'm sure, are aware
how much,
of that.
You know, people can impact one another and the good that comes out of all
of
this. I know that you also interviewed families of Holocaust survivors and two such very good friends. And they were Ruth Gold and Gussie Rados, who used to cook and talk and be together. And I just love what the plaque had said. Like the four Holocaust survivors, the bench inscribed for them withstood a great deal, including Superstorm Sandy in 2012, and will continue to represent their lives. If you sit on the bench, you just might hear Ruth and Gussie's banter and smell the brisket. Sit down, take a rest. You'll be glad you stopped by.
Yeah, it's interesting. Just a quick aside about that. These four people were lifelong friends, if you will. And for some reason, when they came to this country, they decided to go upstate to the Catskills and invest in a chicken farm.
Right.
So they stayed there and it became very well known, as I guess around Liberty, New York, their chicken farm was very, very well known. I'm not sure if it's still there now.
And I understand that in June, you had about 250 people who went to the Long Beach Hotel where everybody was reunited with the families. Please share with me, what was that about?
Well, for the distribution, the day of the distribution of the book, now the only thing they had seen prior to this was their page for approval.
Oh,
they had not
thanks.
Seen what was lying ahead of them. And when they came in, we had a very, very nice spread for them, and we had a very nice program for them.
How touching, how exciting
yeah.
for each person, and then to meet you.
Yeah, it was very, as people had said to me, I was, I guess, too much in the middle of it. I couldn't see the forest from the trees, so
right,
to speak.
Right, right.
But they said the emotion and the feeling that was part of this event was palpable. It was actually
absolutely,
so,
absolutely.
Yeah, that was a great moment for them, and that's what it was all about. All this work, obviously, is more than compensated in, you know, just looking at the people and talking to them and seeing that you did make a difference. You know,
well, I'll tell you, this reflections are tribute to the benches of Long Beach and the people involved. Extraordinary. We have a quick video to share with everybody a little bit about this, as a matter of fact, before we continue with a couple more people.
Okay. This is a storehouse for memories. These are the benches that Long Beach officials rushed to dry land when Hurricane Sandy virtually demolished their boardwalk. The 2-mile boardwalk is being rebuilt with a solid foundation. Officials hope to finish by the end of this year.
This is my bench, to be exact.
For one citizen, a sentimental task, Jeffrey Singer has put together a book containing the story of each bench, 700 family stories. A labor of love.
That's where the father or grandfather would sit, day after day and look at the ocean. Talking about people who lived here 50, 60, maybe 70 years, and brought up children and grandchildren, and they also went to the beach with their parents and grandparents. So, you know, it's a whole history.
I think so, Tommy, eventually.
For the Guidos, and son, a spiritual inscription.
It's a prayer, basically, just saying that she's safely home with the Lord after being like borrowed to us, basically, for a certain amount of time. She's back where she belongs.
The mother was the daughter of a Coast Guardsman who moved from port to port. She married in Long Beach.
This was kind of like a seamless place for her to come, you know, living near the water, coming down to visit. When I see that bench, it's just like a final tribute to her. That's something, a piece of me that I'll always have.
Greg and Ann Freed met at Bellevue. He was a surgeon, she a nurse. They decided to memorialize both sets of parents.
It's a very nice, sentimental thing. And we like to see people sitting on it and enjoying it and watching the ocean.
This is my brother's.
Among the honored, a man named Michael. He died suddenly at 56 after a life of good works, promoting education in Jordan, Israel, and Bangladesh.
And he went into schools.
His sister, Judy Werner, says he reminded her of the fable of the 1970s, Jonathan Seagull.
He was one of a kind, and he soared above all.
When they dedicated the bench on a winter's day, she recalls something unusual happened.
A whole flock of seagulls just stood at attention with one seagull standing in the front of them. And when the ceremony was finally over, they all flew away. I think it was my brother. I think it was his spirit that got the seagulls there.
On the benches of Long Beach, in the wake of a terrible storm, lie warm memories of family devotion and love. In Long Beach, Gabe Pressman, News 4 New York.
What do you think about seeing something like that?
Well, I've recounted that particular story on a number of occasions.
Yes.
And it puts the hair on your neck almost standing and say, really, could that really happen? I spoke to that woman at length, and yes, that's the way it really was.
Well, I love the book, but now I'd like to talk a little bit about you, Jeff. And I'm holding this up with the cover. And this is very special, this cover. because your son actually gave this to you. It was a painting, right?
Yes.
And tell us what happened on that Thanksgiving day.
After Thanksgiving, it was 11 years ago now. Actually, I was standing on the boardwalk, and my son, I was supposed to be helping my son help because his car was stalled somewhere near the boardwalk, and they got me on the boardwalk, and then all of a sudden I see my son coming up with his wife, and then I see my my other son Darren, who did the actual painting.
Beautiful.
And I said, "What are they doing here?" And they said, "Well, sit down here." And I sat on this bench, and they said, "Look around." And I did look around, and I didn't understand. They said, "Okay, stand up." They didn't say stand up, stupid, but they said, stand up already. Look. And then I looked down, and there was the plaque. With this very nice inscription. And it was quite an emotional moment.
You must have lost it at that particular
point.
Yeah,
that was, and then my son Darren, who did this painting, gave that to me probably a few months later.
Oh.
And it was lovely. It's right by Pole 60,
Pole
the old
60.
Pole 60, because that was how old I was
at that time.
And yeah, it was a wonderful experience.
Let's also talk about your background in education.
Okay. I gave 34 or 35 years of my life to New York City Board of Ed as an English teacher.
Mm-hmm.
But mainly I focused on dropout prevention.
Right.
And I taught in a number of alternative schools. This was before alternative school was the rage, if you will. In fact, it was sort of strange that somebody would volunteer to teach in a school like this. These were bright kids who, at that time, that was in the early 70s, were dropping out of school. At least thinking about dropping out of school. And I said, no, they are good students.
Good
you
kids.
Just got to give them the right atmosphere, and
mm-hmm.
you got to
mm-hmm.
believe in them. And so I started my own school, and
unbelievable.
35 years later, okay, I called it a day, but hopefully I affected many students along the way.
Well, let me ask you something. We were talking before, because I know that you had something traumatic happen to you as a child, and this
mm-hmm.
impacted your life. It gave you something to think about, how you're making a difference in the lives of others, how you're giving back to other people.
Mm-hmm.
And do you think it was because of the illness? And share with everybody what that was.
Okay, what I will do, this is actually a preface to the second book that's coming out. I call it The Supplement. But it's a preface. I'm not going to read the whole thing. I'm just going to do a paragraph.
What's the name of the second one? The first one is Reflection.
This is Reflection, second edition.
Okay.
In addition to the supplement of another 75 stories, there's going to be a special supplement for the 9/11 victims and also the tragedies of that sort. But just the tribute plaques themselves with the Gettysburg Address on the top.
And Jeff, where does the money go from all of this?
All of the money's go to charities to help children in Long Beach. And
beautiful.
whatever I have, they get it.
Important to know.
Yes, thank you for asking. I'll just quickly it's called The Light. And it's sort of a story
mm-hmm.
of how this all came about. At approximately 4:30 in the afternoon on August 28th, 1949, an ambulance pulled into the emergency exit of Queens General Hospital and deposited its 6-year-old polio victim. Another statistic of that brutal summer when parents voluntarily quarantined their children behind locked doors and drawn blinds for fear that theirs would be next. Now I'll skip a little bit. 20 years later, the boy was now a 26-year-old man, still trying to find his place in the world, believing that he had been spared for a reason. He knew he was still here to make a difference, but where? How? The answer came one night in the early spring of 1968, that awful spring that began with a rifle shot in Memphis, Tennessee, and ended 2 months later on a pantry kitchen floor in Los Angeles, California. Somewhere in between the two events, he found himself walking down a deserted bicycle path when he came upon a group of teenagers partying. They offered him a beer and some weed, but he declined both. He spoke with them for a while, trying to understand this new way of thinking, this burgeoning new lifestyle, and then the light went on. And at the end of that, bottom of the page, it's my my own plaque, and it says, "Happy 60th birthday, Jeffrey Singer. A teacher affects eternity. He can never tell where his influence stops."
Thank you so much. So you have made a difference in so many different ways. And we look forward to the book coming out. If people want to reach you, how can they do so?
Well, two ways. They can go on the website, mm-hmm. www.benchmensch.com, or they can go to benchmensch at AOL.com, and that would be directly to me. That's my email address.
Thank you so much. We'll be right back, and when we come back, we are going to be with Mike and Bill, and I hope you'll stay and join us for Network USA. Be right back.
Welcome to Formula Auto Wash, where every day is a great day for a car wash. Open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Sundays, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Detailing packages for every budget, starting out at $29.99. 100% hand wash and detail center. Hogs hair and microfiber brushes and mitts. Proudly using Ecolab Blue Coral soaps and waxes. Formula Auto Wash has served the community for over 30 years. Senior discounts all day, every day. Ladies Day Wednesday, $3 off any wash. Early bird discount Monday through Thursday till 9:30 a.m. Check out our website, formulaautowash.com.
Hi guys from Network USA. Before we actually talk about all that you're doing and all the change that you are indeed affecting and how positive these responses have been, I do want to mention that I love smartphone, computers, texting, but I have had a beef with that recently. I feel that a lot of people, particularly younger people, are doing so much of that that I think we're losing the one-on-one experience. And I'm excited about what the two of you have come up with, because what's old is new again. And by that I mean years ago, if you were kind of cowardly, you get on the phone and maybe break a date. Today I'm hearing about people breaking engagements, texting, computers. And what you have done is put the person back into business and into relationships. So first of all, I want to say welcome, Mike. Welcome,
Bill.
Thank you for that.
I thank you, Gail. I appreciate that.
Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about that. Why is that such a necessity today?
Sure. You know, one-on-one is definitely a key role now into growing businesses. You know, as the market changes, as the world changes, you know, there's a lot of people that don't know what route to go down. You know, I'm stuck. Direct mail doesn't work for me. You know, it's all about personality now. It's all about making that connection. It's all about that number one word that starts with an R, relationships.
So agree with you. Sometimes you have to see LOL and say, oh, that's what they meant. They were kidding. But when you're one-on-one, you can see the eyes, you can see the body movements,
right.
You can get it. And you can feel that passion that a person might have for something particular like that. Now, Mike, you're very young. You came out of, Hofstra. You went into your own business.
Correct.
You had insurance. And same, Bill, you were into, you were doing graphic design, trade. And the two of you found each other and joined this. Tell me very briefly how that happened.
I'll tell you briefly. You can jump right in.
Sure.
You know, I started Lime Social in March of 2012.
Long Island Magazine for Entrepreneurs.
Right, also known as learning, informing, mentoring, and exchanging. Four things you do when you network. I grew it to one of the largest networking organizations on Long Island. I met my partner, Bill. He ran Network New York. We decided to merge and rebrand Lime Social to Network USA.
Going back to what you said about the face-to-face.
Yes.
Networking is so powerful when you use it correctly and you really get on that personal level of building the business and building relationships, and I fell in love with that. Customer service is one thing, but when you are actually helping somebody build a business and build relationships, it's a completely different story. So when we met, we had the big vision of what this could be and how big it could be, and it was awesome.
And a match was made?
Yeah, it was.
Now,
it was good.
You are both extremely busy. You're all over the place. You have newlywed, you have a 2-year-old child and wife. So how do you balance this? Because I really think life is about balances. I know there's trading off, but how do you balance it or don't you?
Well, my wife wants me to work. It's like, you make the money or you're out.
So I gotta
make the money.
I think my wife agrees with that.
You know, my wife loves my partner. You know, and I think vice versa. You know, I have two families. My family is my business, and my family is my wife. And thankfully, and I speak for Bill also, our wives are part of our business.
Yeah.
So it's actually easier.
So everybody is involved.
Everybody's in it. It's a family business. You know, that's what we believe in.
There's nothing better than going home to.
No.
What's that, Bill? Nothing better than what?
Going home to my little girl. You know, it's
a
long
day of meetings
and everything. And
you know what you're doing for them, as well as for other people, and making a difference, as we'll get into, in the lives of others. Now, the two of you are very young, and yet you're extremely successful. So, Mike, I'm going to start with you. I'd like 3 reasons why you believe it's so successful, and expand upon that.
Sure. You know, I like to say that I'm successful, but I have a lot more to learn. You know,
good.
I believe success comes from within. So, you know, my personality is definitely a key, and I have a vision. You know, I come from an entrepreneurial family.
Right.
So when I got out of college, I know that I wanted to make it on my own. I wanted to start a business and do what I love. You know, you got to do what you love.
Right.
If you do what you love and you have the passion, You're a success in itself.
That key is that word passion.
You know, you are a success in itself. And that's why I think I'm successful, because I love what I do, I'm happy, and my personality just rides with it.
And Bill, how about yourself? What would you like to add to that?
The vision, unfortunately I have to take your vision, because that's a really good one. The vision, when you know, the harder you work with something, you know, bigger and greater, the more fulfilling it is at the end of the day. I'm going to also go with relationships, you know, the relationships that I've built,
beautiful.
You know, like Mike and everybody
else. And the charities
that we're going to speak about. Mm-hmm. The more relationships we make and build, the further we'll get and you know, fulfill the Network USA.
How is Network USA different than other networking groups?
You know, we like to say that we are not in competition with anybody. You know, Network USA is not looking to take over anybody. We are looking to add to everything. You know, we like to say that we're a marketing source based on a networking platform. And what I mean by that is we are basically a marketing wholesaler. Mm-hmm. A small, medium, or large-sized business can come to us and say, I've spent thousands of dollars on all these type of marketing stuff. I don't know what works. There's so many networking groups. What works? So we say, don't worry about it. Spend half of that. Mm-hmm. We'll build an actual campaign around what you need. That's what's key. You need what you know what you need.
Right.
Let us build that around you.
So you interview them, you meet with the people.
Without question.
Let me go over some of the things. When I did some research, I was quite impressed with what marketing entails. And you can jump in at any time to explain it by all means.
Sure.
And I love it that you're doing the business aspect, and I hear a lot of the graphic arts coming from you, Bill.
Yeah.
You have the ad campaign.
Right, so that's the LIME. That's the Long Island Magazine for Entrepreneurs. We have the only business-to-business exclusive magazine on Long Island where we are spotlighting individuals not businesses.
And that one is educational and informative,
correct.
I'm correct.
Without question.
Okay. Media relations, print, TV, radio.
Yes. We are, the rate that we're growing, we are showing people that there are other outlets and avenues of advertising and various media to get their business out there and their mission and their statement out
there. So social media is good,
but
it shouldn't take the place of our one-on-one.
You shouldn't be on Facebook all day just trying to promote your business.
Right,
there are other outlets out there, the face-to-face and the magazine, et cetera.
Artistic websites, would that be your domain? Or
that's a specialty.
Well,
that's your specialty.
Websites should be, you know, very informative. The Network USA website is informative. It gets to the point of what we're building and what we're trying to get across. It comes down to our personalities and trying to sell our business and sell Network USA. The more personal, that's where you'll get the most information.
Yeah, when I went to the networking event, quite impressive actually. There were a few hundred people, balloons, name tags, speakers, and different stations set up.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you, it was just delightful. This was over at Jewel in Melville.
Correct.
Yes.
And there was some hors d'oeuvre, and it was just such a wonderful, happy occasion. Yeah. I had the name tag, people approached, people who didn't know me. I met different people. So I totally understand that. How are you building community relationships?
Sure. Well, the community relationships basically comes with that networking. We are building a networking platform, a networking community where other businesses can come together in the community, both on the business side and the consumer side, to help build business.
So you're providing jobs?
Without question.
So which is in this economy, which is a wonderful thing to be doing. And you're also giving back to the community by doing this.
We believe in definitely giving back. That's why we have that charity.
All right, and you also have brochures, websites, press releases, marketing guidance, referrals, which are extremely important.
Extremely.
So why should somebody come to you then? And how much does it cost? And how do they do it?
Great. Well, let me just get to the cost first, because that's what the number one question usually is how much is this going to spend?
That's what people want to know.
Because we're a marketing organization based on a networking platform, we have a membership, a yearly membership. It's only $100.
Okay.
For $100, you get value. That's the key. There's a lot of organizations, associations out there that don't have value. Mm-hmm. So the value that we bring is for that $100, you get lead lists. You get a free ad in our magazine.
Okay.
You get a free ticket to our Subway Series networking event. We
Which
actually
is coming
teamed up
this summer.
This May, May 13th, we will be at Yankee Stadium doing a Subway Series networking event. You get $1,000 in trade money We are the only.
What does that mean? Excuse
we're
me.
The only. No, please. We're yeah. the only organization, marketing company that has its own monetary system.
Okay.
Bill built the trade system, so.
Yeah. Well, I mean.
Yeah.
Behind Network USA, that not only the networking and the building of the business, but what other way can we help community businesses save money?
Okay.
Then have businesses in our network, in our community, community of businesses, trade money, save money for other things, you know,
right.
in the economy and everything else. People, business-wise, they need to save money and cut corners just to
Excellent.
Make, you know, everyday meat. So what we do is we developed a system where now our members can trade without using cash with other members.
And I'll just finish answering
no,
your question.
Right, go ahead.
So for that $100, you get all of that. You get admission to the events.
Okay.
But there are other a la carte sponsorship packages, and that's what's great and that's what's different. And that's why people should come to us, is the fact that we're not going to say $5,000, this is what you get,
That's it.
What we do is say, okay, what marketing do you need?
Individualize it.
Because you know your business more than we do, but we know how to market.
Right.
So what do you need? What's your budget? Let's put something together. Mm-hmm. But the key part is that let's say something doesn't work. We have a trade marketed platform where now we can just swap something, and now they don't have to go spend another $1,000 someplace else.
Right, excellent.
There's always something that works.
So it's a win-win situation.
It's a win-win situation because they get business.
Yeah. Right. Let's look at some of your subsidiaries, if you may.
Sure.
Okay, your roundtable executive discussion called RED. Mm-hmm. Let's go a little bit into that because you have 20 people, one speaker. Explain that.
Sure. It's basically a one per industry. And the reason why I use my quotes is because we allow our members to actually bounce from chapter to chapter to get to know everybody.
Oh.
You know, we want to build a community of businesses, not a competition of businesses.
I love that. I love that you keep saying that. There's enough for everybody.
There's enough for everybody. So it's a one per industry that someone can come in. We actually start groups for them. You know, like Trend, for example, Transparent Real Estate Network, we actually started for a title individual who wanted to reach real estate, the real estate market. So we actually took a title person and we actually started a group around her, invited real estate brokers, mortgage brokers, title people, inspections, all et cetera, et cetera.
Okay, you have Social X.
So SocialX basically is take the idea of LinkedIn and take the idea of, let's say, JDate or Match.com, merge them together.
Got it.
So basically what that is I take you, an individual business, and I meet and I put you with three or four different industries, same synergy. I throw you into a breakfast, lunch, or dinner on your schedule.
Right.
It's like speed dating.
Right.
So every single week, every other week, you're basically forced to meet the people you want to meet. So instead of seeing the same people every week, or instead of going to an event where there's 200 people and you can't see everybody.
Right, you can't see everybody.
Now you tell us who you want to meet. We'll put you into a breakfast, lunch, or dinner.
Fabulous.
And you'll meet them, speed dating.
What a great way to do it. You go and you have to confront, you have to meet. Yeah. The referrals from this have to be extraordinary.
It's one of our most popular.
Well, now you're coming to one of my most popular. I love this quote. You know where I'm going with this.
I exactly know where you're going.
Giving is not an afterthought to success, but rather it's the foundation.
Amen to that. You know, we are all about charities.
Right.
Okay. You know, there's one thing about making money. There's another thing about giving back to the community.
Giving back.
One of our major charities is called Wheels in Motion Foundation. We actually just started that. We hooked up with Donna Burke and Douglas King.
Right.
And what that basically does, that charity, is we raise money primarily for wheelchair-bound people that need service dogs. But over and above that, what we're doing is we're actually raising money for disabilities in general, both physical and mental. And we wanted to give back to the community in that way and say, listen, disability is not something to stop you.
Right.
It's something
Beautiful.
To push you forward.
Something to encourage you. And I think the other thing that you're doing that's so important is you're showing that there is support for this and that we are definitely a village, a community working together.
The wheels in motion worked out perfect because I do have a brother with that was born with spina bifida.
Really? So this is very
yeah,
important.
It
touches home.
It definitely touches home. Give me some of the questions that people most often ask you so that if you don't have to get that phone call later on and repeat
of
it.
Of course.
But what are the three most popular questions and what are the answers?
Sure. You know, the questions that I think, and if you have any other questions, you know, jump in.
I was going to say, do we get along?
First and foremost, do we get along? Yeah, we always fight. That's why we're a great partner.
We would make a great
TV show, right? We'll take your place. One of the questions is what you mentioned. You know, how are we different?
Yes.
How we're different, and I'll just reiterate it in a short way, is we give back, you know, we basically build a marketing campaign around you.
Okay? Right.
The second thing is what's the value behind us? Okay. People want to know where their money is going, okay? The value behind us is your money is not coming out of your pocket into our pocket. Mm-hmm. We're actually giving back. Mm-hmm. We're building that magazine. We're building that foundation. We're giving back to charity.
Correct.
You know, the third question people would ask is basically, you know, what is Network USA?
How can you help me?
You know, how can you help me?
How can you help me to succeed?
Right.
In this
what
very
can you
poor
do for
economy?
Me?
Got it. What's next for Network USA? I mean, I saw something about 501Cs. I saw something about religion that you can do networking.
The reason why we named it Network USA is because we want to go nationwide.
We want to go nationwide.
You know, we're in contract.
Looks like you're heading that way.
Yeah, we're in contract now, crossing our fingers, to open up in Atlanta and California.
Excellent.
You know, so we hope to do that. You know, we are growing rapidly. We're actually on the verge of actually having our own radio station, a business radio station. So we're growing. You know, we want to give back to the community.
Very quickly, last question as we wrap it up.
Go for
where do you see yourselves 10 years from now?
I'll talk about me personally, and then you can go. You know, 10 years from now, I hope to be in Florida laying on a beach. No, I'm just kidding. In 10 years from now, I plan on doing the same thing that I'm doing now.
Beautiful.
I plan on advocating about networking. Good. I plan on advocating about businesses, and I plan on advocating about why Network USA is needed in America and internationally.
Bill, same thing, pretty much.
And
all right. Well, growing. I want to thank the two of you. I know you got so much information out there.
Thank you, Gail.
When we come back, I'm going to be talking to Tommy Maley, about Ronald McDonald House on Long Island.
Great.
Be right back.
For professional motorcycle transport and towing, think Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing. Proudly serving all of Long Island, we feature expert handling and 24/7 service. So send a limo for your toy with Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing.
Are you planning an event and want to include entertainment, but you're not sure where to turn?
Act1Entertainment.net has provided over 1,500 events with quality, affordable live entertainment at private parties, corporate affairs, festivals, bike rallies, and more. Act 1 will fit into your budget. They're friendly, reliable, and do all the legwork for you. They take all major credit cards. Log on to Act1Entertainment.net for a free, no-obligation price quote or call 631-758-3505 for a brochure.
You'll be happy you did.
Hi, Tom Maley, who is one of the owners of Madhouse TV. First of all, I just want to say, I love it here. You guys are amazing. You have definitely made this a family for me and the opportunity to get out to get all this information. And recently had Michael from Ronald McDonald House who came on, and after listening to him and after you and we talked to him, we went to Ronald McDonald House, which was an extraordinary experience. What was it like for you?
You know, I want to say that the ambiance was like going to Disney World because they did such an unbelievable job with setting up this home for these kids. Actually, for the parents of the kids.
Families,
and, you know, they made, you know, going through this place, you know, when you go there, you had a whole different perspective of what it would look like. And as you started walking through, the emotions of what these families and these kids must be going through was unbelievable. And you know, you and I then started talking, and I said, you know, listen, we have the power to get out around the world, and why not do something with this ability that we have to broadcast and let people literally all over the world know what's going on here. And you know, it's just it's amazing, Gail, how things just fall into place. So, make a long story short, and after you know of spending a great time with Mike and putting this whole thing together with the help of obviously you, Shelley, my partner Tom, Vicky, and Janine, we will be broadcasting live from Ronald McDonald House in New High Park on Saturday. You know, this is a great opportunity. We put, as you know, Madhouse TV is unique in its own way. And we have been in 70-some-odd countries. We've been around the world. We have an audience in Argentina and down south in Africa, Australia, United States, England. You know, I mean, literally all over the world. And to think that we're going to be able to now share that with the world and let them see what's going on here. And, you know, listen, at the end of the day, we're hoping that by putting on this so-called telethon that we're going to be doing, and I'm going to go through.
Right, you'll go through that.
Tommy, my partner Tommy, was able to put this incredible lineup together of people that will be singing Christmas carols and music. It's going to be great. Listen, we're going to be putting up numbers and, you know, phone numbers. And through the Ronald McDonald Foundation, you'll be able to donate. Listen, they put this house together and they rely on you people. They rely on donations. They rely on the help, pennies, nickels, dimes,
whatever
anything.
You're able to
anything
contribute.
At all, because it all adds up at the end of the day.
It does.
So, you know, Madhouse TV and Madhouse Productions decided, you know what, we're going to do our part to get
it
out to you
That's
folks.
Right.
Now it's, you got to do your part to help out these kids and
and we want
the
them
families.
To come at 1 o'clock to 5 o'clock. I know I'm going to be interviewing quite a few people. We have politicians. We have wonderful entertainment, which you're going to cover in a minute.
Yeah.
We will have some refreshments. But above all, we will have children and families.
Yeah, that's going to be the unique
and
part.
The pictures are being shown right now as we speak of the different parts of Ronald McDonald House.
Oh, wow. Are they up? I don't even see them.
Share,
Yeah, they up?
Yeah.
But, yeah, the you know, listen, come on down Saturday. The show starts at 1 o'clock. If you want to come down to Ronald McDonald House in New High Park, if you want to tune in, very important. We created a website. Instead of creating an average link through Madhouse TV, if you simply get on the computer and go to ronaldmcdonaldchristmas.com, there we are.
There you are.
It's as simple as that. ronaldmcdonaldchristmas.com, 1 o'clock, this Saturday from 1 to 5.
Now, I understand the pictures weren't shown, but if people come to this, they're going to see what? Tell me about the entertainment.
Well, let me see if I can do this. I got to put on my eyes here for a second, because
even though you're the owner of Madhouse TV, we have a couple of minutes left.
Okay, yes, even I get scrutinized if I go over. Okay, real quick, Ronald McDonald, Kids Stock the House. Tell us about Kids Stock the House, real quick.
They're a wonderful organization from out east. They've raised a few hundred dollars, and they're going to contribute in the name of someone who lost. Dog died, and they're going to do this over at Ronald McDonald.
Now, they're singers. They're a bunch of kids that are singers.
There's also going to be a singer from the group.
From the group.
Wonderful kids.
Okay, Jacqueline Monique. Have I got that
right? Jacqueline Minaj.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Katie Zimmer. If you guys have ever had a chance to see this girl, since how old is Katie?
Oh, she's Katie is
12?
She's 14.
Unbelievable. Diana Berman. I hope I got that right.
Diane Bauman.
Bauman. Okay. See, I'm terrible with names, but that's my partner's fault because he's always aggravating.
She's so celebrated singer. She's been with so many different groups. And go ahead.
All right. We have, now this is, these are headliners here. Amber Ferrari is going to be
there. I just did a video with her.
Amber Ferrari is going to be with us Saturday. She's unbelievable with her husband, Chris. Christina LaPiano.
Right.
Her husband, Jim, again, singer-songwriters, they're going to be there.
Be
Lucille Morris, unbelievable. I believe she plays the flute. Another headliner. She's going to be there. And we have, you know, there's just so many here. And of course, Andre LaSalle is going to be there. Andre LaSalle and
Tommy Moore
is going to be singing. Now, he asked me to get up and sing, and of course, I decided not to, only because I didn't want to embarrass him, and I didn't want to take him away from the stage. No. But no, that's not true. Tommy Moore is going to be there, and he's going to be singing, and it's going to be great.
This is going to be a wonderful day of fun, frolicking. And you know what? This is the time to give. It's a time of goodwill. So I really hope that you will come to this, speak with us, I'll interview, and we're going to have a great time. Yeah. And best of all, it's for the children.
Yeah, listen, people, before we go, just do me a favor. You know, sometimes we don't realize how lucky we have it, you know. And when you see these families that are going through these tough times in these homes, it's organizations like the Ronald McDonald Foundation that puts this all together. Right. But they need help. They need the help to do this. And we're hoping that you guys tune in. You'll see the number to donate. Listen, whether it's a dollar, whether it's 50 cents, it doesn't matter.
From the heart.
All right? Whatever you can do, it adds up. And we're doing this now. We're going to ask you people to tune in on Saturday, 1 o'clock, December 14th, RonaldMcDonaldChristmas.com, and let's just make it happen for these kids and these families. And, Gail, we couldn't do it without you, obviously. And we hope everybody just does what they need to do.
I'd like to thank my guests tonight. We have Jeff, Bill, and Mike, and, of course, you. And I hope I see you there this weekend. I think it's time to say goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.